a late night video. Who knew? Well, anyway, please excuse the warm color in my room. This is not a white balancing issue. In fact, the white balance is perfect because, as you can see here on my phone, everything looks great. I just have my office set to wonderful warm color lights because they don't kill your eyes. Anyway, I want to reminisce about MS-DOS, or in this case, PC-DOS. Why? Well, you see, I grew up on using DOS. My first computer ran DOS 3. In fact, this here is the operating system manual in disks for my first computer's operating system. And you see, this is just so, how do I say this? Sentimental. Yeah, this is very sentimental to me because MS-DOS or PC-DOS, well, I did so much with it. I learned some of the commands on my own, never opening the book. So let me give you a little history lesson. We all remember the IBM PS2 Model 25 I always used to do a video about, which is now actually sitting in that closet. I still have it. I just don't really use it anymore because now I just emulate DOSBox if I really want to, or boot my computer up into FreeDOS if I want to. Well, let's talk a little sentimental. I'm not entirely certain what year it was when I first was introduced to DOS. I want to say, oh man, maybe 1992, 1993. So I was 6 years old when I first used a computer. And I remember my father would put me in PFS First Choice, which is a word processor. It's actually one of the earliest word processors I've used, basically. And I'll tell you what, I would just slam the keyboard as much as I can because, oh yeah, gotta love it. You know, let's see here. I'm just pulling up a program so I can give you some sounds for it. So yeah, I'd be using PFS First Choice and just bashing away. And you bet it was a Model M keyboard that sounded just like this. In fact, it was a Model M Space Saver keyboard because that's usually what the Model 25s actually came with. A lot of pictures show them coming actually with a full-size keyboard, but I believe that was an option because my father would not have gotten any of the options. In fact, he didn't get a Model 25 with a hard drive or even 640K of RAM, and yet it came with the Model M Space Saver. I think that was the cheaper alternative, which is ironic because now that keyboard is worth the most. May mine rest in peace. I went to bolt mod it because a lot of the rivets ended up popping and the keyboard ended up dying, and well, I moved out and let's just say the keyboard met its doom. It didn't make it in the move. Oh, I still hurt from that. Anyway, once I started really learning DOS, though, this was what I had. This is the booklet that comes with DOS 3.3. I think this might be 3.31 or 3.30. I don't remember. Anyway, it is, yes, a binder. Now, when was the last time you remember an operating system came in a hard binder? I don't remember. And you know what's funny is it's just illustrated so well with color. You know, who even remembers this stuff? I mean, this is how I learned to use a computer. I remember I read this one first, the user guide. I remember just loving all the photos it had, like, for example, here, what is DOS? Be sure to full screen it so you can see it. Yes, I mean, this is just how I learned how to use a computer. And it's funny, And I think I just saw it. I think it just mentioned the PC Junior. Did it? Because that actually will be surprising if this just mentioned the PC Junior. Or maybe it did. No, it does. It does mention the PC Junior. Anyway, this was just how I got started, how to use it, and how to disk copy. And I remember learning about high-density floppies, low-density floppies, and how you can manipulate files and stuff like that between them. And I'm trying to see if I can find it real quick, because it's something that a lot of new people to vintage computers don't know. Well, they tend to try to use like a high-density drive on low-density disks, blah, 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 and they end up running to old issues that we used to live with back in the day. I'm just trying to see if I can find that. Oh, look at this. It's a really bad illustration, but that sure looks like an IBM Selectric. I mean, I would hope so. It's IBM. Let's see. Displaying what's in the file. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. This might not be showing me what I'm... Okay. Shows you internal commands. And this is a big one, another big one. When people do like a sysa or something and they wonder why it's some commands just don't work. Difference between internal commands and external commands. External commands being actual programs. You know, I mean, you learn so much here. And this little book is only the beginning. Because you also get the quick reference card. Oh yeah, and it teaches you Edlin. Who remembers using Edlin? More like, who doesn't want to remember using Edlin because Edlin sucked. But anyway, then you got the binder of pages. And it's still in color, mind you. This is still in color. It just doesn't have the cartoon characters anymore because now we're actually showing how to use things like F-disk, stuff like that. But then, oh, my favorite part, though, is all the way at the back. Because I remember as a kid, and this was where my naiveness came in place, because contrary to what some people think, they seem to think that I know computers since I was a little kid. Well, no, not really. Let's be honest here. I don't. So, when I used DOS, I used this floppy disk. But I always wondered what machine this was for. So, it's funny. Because my father was telling me when he bought the Model 25, it didn't come at all with the operating system. He had to buy it himself, which means when he bought this, it also came with a 5 1/4 inch disk because you don't know what machine you're gonna be buying it for. And I believe these are 360K disks. They're obviously not high density. So I'm pretty certain these are 360K. But, you know, it's just... There's so many memories of using MS-DOS and just growing up on it. And I still look back at these manuals. Like, if I'm using MS-DOS today, for any reason, either in DOSBox or an emulator, or even just at the Windows command prompt, because some of these things still work. Not everything. But some of like the internal commands still work, and I learn a few things, like how to make batch files and things like that. I learned it all from this, and I don't know. They say the past was such simpler times, and well, yeah. But let's be honest, MS-DOS wasn't easy compared to like something like Windows. But it was simpler. There's no doubt about that. I mean, it even tells you, like right here, what are invalid characters and file names. And it's so funny. It's like, this is still valid today. It's still valid because these are invalid. You know, like, some of these things just haven't changed over the years as far as Windows is concerned. Linux or Unix in general, it don't really care. I mean, it'll let you do it. It also lets you hose your machine if you really want to. I think Windows these days prevents you from deleting System 32. But DOS wasn't like that. DOS would let you pretty much nuke your machine, too. So, yeah, just reminiscing using DOS, I mean, this is what I grew up with, man. And I still keep this on my desk just as a reminder of where I came from using computers. This is where it all began for me. And you probably can't even tell. It has a lovely, lovely texture. Everything. It's all textured. Now, it used to have a paper around it. Unfortunately, that paper is destroyed. It got chewed up a few years ago. And I didn't even realize this was written on it under that entire time. So this actually looks better anyway, in my opinion. But I know some purists will be like, you should have kept the paper. It could be worth so much money these days. I'm not selling it. This is for me. This is my sentimental nature. Anyway, YouTube, that's all I wanted to talk about. I just wanted to talk about DOS, just the sentimental value to it to me, and how I grew up using computers. Oh, and if my father's watching this, he would love to tell you about the time when we got our first 486 computer, which was the machine that replaced the Model 25, and the time he put a BIOS lock to prevent me from using it, except I broke into the BIOS and changed the password on him. That's when I learned I can crack into machines. And that's where I started really becoming the computer person that everyone went to. Have a good one, YouTube.